Does Pinterest also feel overused for you nowadays? And do you feel like you've seen all those pictures already? If yes, today I'm gonna introduce you to a powerful trio of absolutely unique design and inspiration tools. These tools will help you not only find and develop ideas from scratch, create something that doesn't exist, but also illustrate it yourself, making it look realistic, yet artistic, and truly extraordinary. If your action was yes to any of these aspects, let's start the design process together. If you're new here, hi, I'm Iana, and I transform spaces and objects into art using the power of digital drawing, showing creatives worldwide that everything is possible. So let me show you this interior first. This interior was completely designed and developed on my iPad with the help of the following resources. And yes, it's time to take notes. AI, Midjourney to be precise, interior magazine Ideat, my absolute go-to source of inspiration, and the Procreate app, where everything comes together. These are the resources we'll be working with today. Also in this video, I'll prove to you why working with artificial intelligence is way more beneficial than being afraid that it'll replace you. So, how did my design process start? First, I had a vision of what my future interior should look like. A living room with a warm, earthy ambiance, cozy feel, and warm wood tones. In the past, I used to browse through Pinterest for idea research, but I noticed that a lot of interiors out there looked very familiar. So instead, I developed my own design routine. This time, I started with research from my all-time favorite design magazine, which offers an unlimited furniture and design collection from different designers, studios, architects and artists, and has educated my own work enormously. Okay, I said unlimited because I've been buying this magazine since 2017 and haven't thrown away any of their editions. And it looks like I'm gonna need a separate room for them soon, but anyway. During my research, I found a page with some of the furniture items by Fendi Casa. I adore this brand so much and have already put a potential collaboration with them on my visualization board. So what I did was I googled those particular furniture items I found in the magazine and studied their interiors in more detail. And then I found something that truly clicked with my inner vision. This gorgeous interior. Bingo! The style I've been searching for. What a perfect blend of contemporary design and natural elements with truly unique character. And I especially like all those contrasts, whether they're color contrasts or geometric contrasts. And speaking about geometric contrasts, I think this white spherical sculpture needs a separate video because, in my opinion, it adds such a unique artistic flair to the space. And since we merge interior and art on this channel, I had to pick the interior accordingly. So, before I turn into design novelist here, let's get back to our design. So, we stopped at the Fendi Casa website, right? My next step in this design process was asking Midjourney to create some similar interiors, which I'll use inspiration for my final design. If you have no clue what Midjourney is, it's a tool that helps you generate images from the prompts you write. And now, is AI going to replace all creative skills and is the end for artists and designers and other creative fields? I'll explain this in an easy way. AI doesn't create the vision or ideas, but it can help you bring that vision to life in new and exciting ways. And it's also about doing more in way less time and at a much lower cost. So while some people are still afraid of it and don't use it because of that fear, others have integrated it into their work, become way more efficient, found an unlimited source of inspiration, become way more productive, and are now way ahead of their competition. So the choice is always yours, you know? Either fear of the unknown, decline the existence of AI or whatever, or simply adapt. And by the way, this book has a perfect explanation of why AI will never replace creativity. And now on to the final design part, the actual illustration based on the ideas and inspirations we've gathered today. Still being inspired by the Fendi Casa brand, I decided to incorporate their sofa into my own design too. The coffee table is from Minotti. And now let's lean back and enjoy the drawing process. I love combining different mediums and tools for the best result. And I want to focus on just one thing. Oh, and by the way, I also filmed a separate video on this topic last week about how to juggle multiple interests and still be successful. See how iPad drawing actually makes the design and drawing part so easy and flexible. And if you want to slightly adjust, let's say, the size or color, go ahead! No need to wait for a computer render. It's all in the palm of your hands. I really wanted to show you a couple of more designs I created on my iPad with the help of Midjourney. And some of them have even become the most viewed content on my Instagram. By the way, if you don't follow me there yet, I'm at And She Draws Back. Time to sum up the video. Everything started with an approximate vision without any details. Then the interior magazine pointed me in the right direction. There I found a match with an interior, followed by finalizing it in Midjourney. And the last step was the drawing part. If you also want to learn how to use an iPad for interior design step by step, start with my free drawing workshop, where you'll get my signature drawing methodology proven by thousands of my students. No talent or drawing skills necessary. And we've come to the final part of this video. Definitely let me know whether you also use an iPad for interior projects or whether it was a discovery for you. In my opinion, it's the most underrated app for interior design for this field. And especially for those who aren't fan of the technical part, let's put it that way. Pure joy and creativity. See you in the next video.